And while the state is staying in stage 4.5, they are giving schools the green light to open back up to its students. Governor Holcomb said local districts should work with their county health department to figure out the best options for their community. Megan St. Torm is working to find out why decisions are being left to local school boards instead of a statewide mandate.
Deciding how and when to start bringing kids back to the classroom isn't easy.
There's so many moving pieces and parts.
District leaders, with guidance from the health department, are creating their own plans for the school year. Some plan to start in person, others completely virtual. One district, Wayne Township, is even offering both options to parents.
I think if you talk to any superintendent, they would tell you this is the most challenging opening of school that they have ever experienced in their career, and probably will.
Some people say they wish the state provided set standards for how school districts should start the year. But Governor Holcomb says that could vary county by county.
And if I have a bias, it is toward home rule and local control and understanding that they know their situation the best. They're not just physical building, but what they're capable to pull off inside the plan that they have to execute.
And he says it's important to get kids back to the classroom.
Yes, we're going to put a premium on live, but it also is about our livelihood, and this includes the way our kids are instructed and what they learn. And we don't want there to be loss there just because we're all going through this the first time.
He and Dr. Box say the state likely will not provide mandates for schools unless counties start to see COVID positivity rates climb to around 10%.
We talked about that yin and yang, the balance of giving us the guidance necessary to be able to open safely, but at the same time, being respective of individual communities and the circumstances that exist.
Working for you, Megan St. Torm, RTV6.